إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة كل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين With double KH, 2KH, or خلاصة الخلاصة, we have a مختصر منهاج القاصدين tonight, which is a summary of the book called Methodology of the Seekers, those people who seek in Allah's pleasure and paradise. So this is the methodology and this is the way has been written and been presented to them by Sheikh أحمد ابن عبد الرحمن قدامة المقدسي رحمة الله عليه and he have a chapter in his book فصل في بيان محبة الله تعالى للعبد ومعناها وبيان علامات محبة العبد لله تعالى chapter concerning explanation the love of Allah سبحانه وتعالى to his slave and its meaning An illustration about some of the signs of the love of the slave to Almighty Allah. He's saying what the meaning is, as for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his slave, so you should know. Now, we're talking here about a special subject, a very, very beautiful subject, and it happened to be that that you be blessed to hear about this because if you get to love Allah, which all of us have to love Allah, this is something that we need to struggle, but for us to be loved by Allah, this is something so great and it's so beautiful to hear about it and that we should be eager and do what we can so we can be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's easy and common to know about people loving Allah or trying to love Allah. But for Allah to love someone, it has to be something special about this person. For Allah to love him. Nevertheless, so here the Shaykh Ibn Qudama al-Maqdisi in this chapter talking about the love of Allah for his slave. Okay, that the master will love his slave. How and what is the sign and things like this. He say, as for the love of Allah to his slave, you should know there is many indication in the Quran concerning this issue. As example in Surah number 2, verse number 222, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ Indeed, Allah loves those who repent, often repent to Allah, and those who profess himself. Tawbah means quitting sinning, and repenting, coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless how many times is that you made a mistake, and that you commit sin, that you try to come back again and again and again. So it's nothing wrong to see the believer seeking forgiveness and repeating it again and again, and he may fall into something wrong or haram, but he will come back again. So التوابين are the plural of those who make tawbah, and tawbah means repentance. And those people who repeat their tawbah, Allah loves those kind of people. And also those people who purify themselves, متطهرين, those who purify themselves. And as we know that purification in Islam has two meaning, at least two meaning. One is purification of the heart, which is very important, okay, very important. And purification of the heart comes before purification of the limbs and the body. Purification of the heart from the illness and the sickness and the disease and the corruption of the sins, because in the heart there is a lot of bad and rusty stuff, and this like hypocrisy, shirk, associating partner beside Allah, and about doubting and not trusting in Allah, the proper trust, and being lustful. All these things is illness and bad things that commit by the heart. And a Muslim should struggle, he or she, to purify their hearts, especially from the shirk. Because with shirk, you could not be acceptable, or your deed can be acceptable. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about the mushrikeen, إِنَّمَا الْمُشْرِكُونَ najas. Indeed, the mushrikeen, the kuffar, those people who associate partner beside Allah, they are impure. Their impurity is because they call in other than Allah, because they trust on other than Allah, because they rely on other than Allah, because they claim, believe that there is other God beside Allah, or that God has a son or an equal or anything like this. So we can see that there is certain behavior that makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love us, and this is two of them, tawbah and tahara. Tawbah and tahara. The second type of tahara purification is the limbs, the arms, the face, the feet, the body. Taking ghusl for Jum'ah, taking ghusl after menses, taking a shower after intimate relation, taking shower when you became a Muslim and take shahada, taking ghusl for Eid and different special Islamic occasion, okay? And also the istinja, washing the private parts or cleaning the private parts whenever you use the bathroom. Doesn't matter if it's number one or number two, you still have to clean yourself properly. Allah loves these things because this is part of the tahara, cleanliness and purification. And also you understand shaving and cutting the fingernails, not to be imitating the kuffar and having long nails. So also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah As-Saff, إن الله يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا. Indeed, Allah loves those who fight in His cause. Okay? One solid rank, one straight rank. So, those who fight for the cause of Allah, and they do it only for Allah's sake, and they will be solid and be together. Allah loves those kind of people. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He had indicated to us in the Quran that He doesn't punish whom He loves. Those people who claim they love Allah, okay, because if Allah loves you, Allah is not going to punish you. And those people, you understand, who claim, but they are not truly loving Allah, Allah told them in Quran in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 18, قُلْ فَلِمَ يُعَذِّبُكُمُ اللَّهُ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ. Say, then why Allah punishing you as a result of your sins? Okay, those kuffar and those mushrikeen in different times and different nations. So Allah saying, قُلْ, say to them, O Muhammad, so why Allah is punishing you? Okay, it's because your sins. Because if you are not committing sin, Allah is not going to be sending wrath on you and earthquake and flood and all these things. But it's because that those people, they only claim the love of Allah, but they are not really loving Allah. And also Allah made a condition for the love to be the forgiveness. Because Allah forgave those whom He loved. As He stated in Surah Al-Imran, verse number 31, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say, O Muhammad, to them, if you really love Allah, so follow me. Following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? Acting upon the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? If you really love Allah, so follow me. Allah will love you and forgive for you your sins. Okay? So those people whom Allah loves, He forgives their sins. And those people whom Allah loves them, He's not going to punish them. Okay? It came in the hadith authentic by Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, إن الله تعالى يقول ما يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. Allah Almighty is saying in the Hadith al-Qudsi, my slave servant continued coming closer to me with optional and voluntarily deeds until I loved him. So your way for getting Allah's love, that doing too much voluntarily. Okay? So as example, you pray Dhuhr. Okay? You pray Sunnah after Dhuhr. You give your zakah, you can give also charity. You fast Ramadan, you can fast every Monday and Thursday. So you don't only stop by fulfilling the obligation. Why? Because doing too much optional deed, voluntarily ibadah, form of worship, this will make Allah loves you. If Allah loves you, Allah forgive your sins for you. If Allah forgive your sins for you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you Jannah. A sign or a mark of Allah's love in His slave that He will test him. That He will test him or her. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا إِبْتَلَاهُ. Whenever Allah loves a slave of Him, He will test him. So what is the difference between the bala, okay, and the punishment? The punishment comes as a result of sins. But the test, what comes is a testing for your faith and to elevate your ranks with Allah. Alright? So actually, let me say it like this. Sickness, illness, sadness, poverty, disturbance. It can be to someone as a form of punishment and can be to the other person a form of elevation for their rank in Jannah, to be blessed more. One of the greatest signs of Allah's love to His slave, that husn al-tadbir, that Allah will discipline him and manage his affair in the proper way. Allah will make way for him from being a child, that he will have a proper parents, a proper education, a lot of proper cultivation, proper guidance, okay? And that Allah will decree the faith in the person's heart. Allah will write the faith for him to make him Muslim. And that Allah will lighten your mind with his light. So as a result of this, you will be after things which is pleasing to Allah. And also will make you run away from things which is displeasing to Allah. Then Allah will take him as a friend by making his affairs easy. And he doesn't allow him to make him to humiliate himself before a human being like him. And he will fix his outward and inward. And he make all his worries to be only one worry. So when the love of Allah became more and more for his servant, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him busy with Allah. And he forget almost about everything else. Did anybody understand anything from this? I know it's not the best English. But believe it or not, even in the Arabic that you have, really, to stop with each word and try to understand is a very deep meaning, very, very, it's so good, you understand that for you, try to understand these things. But because we're talking about the love of Allah and the science of the love, that when Allah loves somebody, what happened to him? So he's saying, the Sheikh is saying that Allah will take care of the person from day one, while he even a child, making a way for him to be protected, to be loved, to be disciplined in the proper way, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he directed him towards the faith, him or her. Allah will lighten his mind, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make him follow the good things and be a distant from the bad, evil things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make all his affairs easy. Allah doesn't make him humiliate himself before anybody else, that he will have a self-esteem, not to go and begging or asking or going after the people for whatever it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of him inwardly and outwardly, and he will make all his worries. And listen carefully to this point. Make all your worries to come to be only one worry. Okay? So instead you worry about the husband and the children and the work and the car and Allah will make all these things to come to be only one thing that you worry about it. And what it is? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your main worry is the hereafter. How I can please my Lord and my Master, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala became more and more to the person, Allah will make him busy with Allah and he almost forget about everything else. So that means Allah became priority in your life. Okay? Allah became a priority in your life. Now, as for the love of Allah, as for the love of the slave servant of Allah to Allah, okay, the other direction, two-way street, huh? As for the love of the slave servant to his master, Almighty Allah, you should know that everybody can claim the love of Allah. It's very easy to make a claim. So, we shouldn't be deceived by claim and the deception of the shaitan. Don't fool yourself when you claim the love of Allah. As long as you are not ready to test yourself and try to check out yourself with the signs of love for Allah. You should ask yourself, and demand evidence. Do you really love Allah? And if you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you really want to meet with Allah? Do you want to go to Jannah? Because we could not imagine somebody loves someone or something and he doesn't want to meet this one or this thing. Okay? Because if you love somebody, you want to spend time with this person, you want to see this person, you want to get closer to this person. So if you claim that you really love Allah, so do you really want to see Allah? And you know, to see Allah, you have to die first, okay? Nevertheless, we understand we hate death. Even the believers, he will hate death. But you have to know that meeting with Allah is not going to happen before death. Some of the early believers had loved death. Some of them, they hate death. But as for those who hate death, this maybe comes as a result of their weakness in the love of Allah. Or that because their love to Allah is mixed with other loves of dunya, people, and things like this. So that you do not have a pure love, because if you have the pure love and your love of Allah is the max in your life, you are not going to hate death, because you know this like a bridge. If you could not cross this bridge, you could not see Allah. So you have to die so you'll be able to see Allah. Or that the person maybe hates the death because he sees that his sins are a lot and he wants to remain more in this life so he can balance his condition and make a repentance and do more good deed. Other people, they see themselves in the beginning of the journey of loving Allah. And he doesn't want this to come to him before he or she prepares himself to meet with Allah. Same way, like if you get the news that you have a friend of yours or relative of you that is coming to visit you. You didn't see them for years and years. But when you get the news of those that you love, to see your uncle or your son or whosoever, but in the same way, when you know that he's coming tomorrow, you don't like it because you want to prepare, get the house clean, you understand, change the living room. So you're hating, but you're loving in the same time. You're happy because you're going to see your relative, okay? But you hate, you understand, because you don't have enough a chance to bring things in the proper order, so it can be good and look nice when you meet him. So in such a condition, a person will be wishing that this visitor, he will delay the trip for at least few hours, so he can meet him in the proper way. And while his heart and mind really in the visit, not to understand that you be sitting with him and worry about how the kitchen look, how this look, and all the things. So the dislikeness here is not because you dislike the guest, but because you did not prepare in the proper way. So this hate of death, it doesn't negate the love of Allah. Okay? But it negates the completion and the perfection of the love of Allah. Anybody understand this French? Anybody? Or used to be Spanish before. It's French now. Anybody understand my French? Tu parles pas français? Okay. Oui. So a person will get himself busy for preparation to meet with Allah. Alright, So we always worry about making the proper preparation so he can meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the signs that a person, if you really want to know that you love in Allah or no, one of the signs is what? That you prefer or give a preference to what Allah loves over what you love. Sometimes we need things, sometimes we want things, sometimes we like things. And sometimes what we want or like is not perfectly right according to Islam. So now if you want to test yourself and to see, do I really love Allah? Now this is going to be a challenge. Are you given, you understand, the preferences of what Allah loves or what you love? Alright? As example, we would like, especially women in general, okay? This only example, I'm not pointing any toes or fingers to anybody, okay? That if she goes, you understand, with makeup, that the people are smiling on her more and things like this, or she alternate her clothes, you understand, she don't have a big headpiece, all these things, she have a scarf, they smiling more to her, they're going to flirt to her, and all these things. But she knows that the proper way of covering. So what she's going to do? She's going to have crossroad here. Which one you going to do? Okay? Which one you going to do? Am I going to do the things which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves more, or the one what I love more? Okay? This will tell you really how much you love to Allah when you put Allah first in your life. So a person will give us his lust and his desires, and also being lazy. And you know that if I get up at night and make 2 rak'at, how much is that Allah loves this and how much is good for my deen. And now you sit, you understand, on the bed debating, okay, especially if it's winter and warm and nice and juicy, cozy, whatever you want to call it, under the blanket or comfort or whatever you call it, okay? And now, I'm going to make wudu, and after this I'm going to lose the sleep, and okay? So now if you want to test your love to Allah, you're going to see, are you going to be lazy and dragging your feet to do these things, or you're going to really kick this cover from you and get up and go make wudu and make 2 rak'at. A person will continue making optional deeds and do more and more until he be loved by Allah. The one who really truly love Allah, he doesn't disobey Allah. Nevertheless, we have to understand that disobedience of Allah does not reroot or remove the root of love to Allah, but it will minimize it or decrease it. Do you understand? Okay. If somebody, as example, they answer the call of their desires, not what Allah wants, can we say this person hates Allah? No. But he did not have the perfect love. So such laziness or such preferring your personal desire over what Allah desires, it doesn't uproot the love, okay, from your heart to Allah, but it shows weakness in the love. It shows that your heart doesn't have a full, complete love for Allah. How many people they love to be healthy, but they still eat in certain things that doctors say don't eat? They know it, and they say, no more salt. Is it right?
Yes.
But, or no more spicy food. And they still sneaking it a little bit, especially if the imam, you understand, makes the tea, and the imam being bad and giving somebody without mentioning his name sugar with his tea, he asked, he said yes, but if his wife will know, the imam will be in trouble, the brother will be in trouble, but I'm not going to say his name. So sometimes he can be sick and the doctor tell you something about certain food, but he's still eating it and you know it's going to harm you. It's going to make you sugar, make you whatever, okay? But he's still doing it. This does not mean that you don't care about your health, but it's still that you're weak. You are not serious enough about your health. That's because knowledge and knowing sometimes can be weak, okay? And the desire can be more stronger. So as a result of this, the person doesn't fulfill the proper cup, fulfill the proper cup of love. We give example with one of hadith. A man by name Nu'ayman, may Allah be pleased with him, he used to be brought to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, he's a Sahabi, and he commit a sin. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will give him the lashings for whatever he did. Okay, he come again, and the Prophet give him the punishment, the lashing. One day, one of the Sahaba curse him. Okay. Because it been brought to the Prophet more than one time. Like, what? You don't have shame? You understand? You're coming again and again. May Allah curse you. So the Prophet ﷺ said to him, do not curse him. فَإِنَّهُ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Don't curse him. Indeed, he loves Allah and his messenger. So he committing a sin and getting the punishment and brought again and again. But the Prophet ﷺ had affirmed and confirmed that this man loved Allah and his messenger. Okay? But the love can be sometimes weak. Alright? But you could not say, okay, you don't love Allah, because you understand you didn't come to the class. No, the person still loves Allah, okay, but he may come late. Is it right, Abdul Rahim? Yeah. So, this doesn't take him out of the total love of Allah, but that weakness can happen sometimes. Also from the signs that the person who loves Allah, that he always in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always the tongue, his tongue or her tongue, remembering Allah. His heart never stops from thinking about Allah. That because if you love somebody or love something, you're always going to mention it. You're always going to think about it. Okay? Like somebody, as example, loves this bechamel or whatever that the sister Zahida do. Alaykum as-salam. He always be talking about when the Thursday will come, the sister going to bring in. Why? Because you love. Or lasagna in Ramadan. Okay? Everybody be talking. Why? Because you like it. Huh? So when you love something, you're always going to be talking about it. So it says that the person who loves Allah, he'll be always talking about Allah. So instead of people to be sitting talking about almost nothing, okay, why they did not talk about something related to Allah? Because you really love Allah, you're going to be always busy talking about Allah and the deen of Allah. And a person who loves something, he will be attached to it. So a sign of love of Allah, that you always remember Allah, you loving his dhikr, you loving the Quran, which is the words of Allah, and you be loving the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Almighty saying in Ala Imran, verse number 31, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Say, if you really love Allah, so follow me. Allah will love you and forgive for you your sins. He said one of the early believers, he said, I found my contentment in calling in Allah. So I became what you call this word when like somebody loves coffee so much or cigarettes so much?
He became
addicted to the Quran. Reading. But in some time, for some reason, I stopped. Okay, I slowed down, slack a little bit. So I saw a dream. In my sleep, somebody telling me, if you really claim the love of Allah, so why did you abandon the book of Allah? Look and check it out and see the nice admonishment that in it. Okay? So that the person who really comes to the love of Allah and get more closer to Allah, when he stop or slow down, like somebody coming to class every day, or coming to Fajr every day, and after this was, I say, man, let me take a break. After 2 days, he could not take it anymore. And even when he got to sleep, he will start to see things about in his dream. Why? Because he already got into this. Okay? So now became his worry, you understand, getting back again on the track. Also, a sign of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that a person will feel good when he's in privacy, calling in Allah and remembering Him, reciting His book. So he will continue with tahajjud night prayer. And he will take advantage of the quietness of the night, and there is no anything to make your mind busy, and you will be there standing calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, indeed, it is a great sign that you love someone, that you always try to call him or her. And you will look for more, not only calling by phone, now you need to spend time together. And now you need to have privacy with this person, okay? And anything that will disturb your relationship with this person, it will be, you understand, too much heavy in your heart. So the same thing, if a person really get to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will get this enjoyment by saying, remembering Allah, reading the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if he stay distant from it for a moment, he will feel that there is something wrong in his life. If a person continue with this privacy and calling in Allah, became the coolness of his eye or her eye, and this will push away all the worries, and the love of Allah will be covering his heart, and he will enjoy his moments with Allah. To such a degree, he doesn't even care or understand about what is going on in this life, unless you have to repeat it many times, because he's busy, you understand, living in a different, almost as if he's not he or she in this life. Also, a sign of the love of Allah, that the person will feel sorry when they miss a class, or a prayer with the jama'ah, or he used to fast every Monday and Thursday, and for some reason he have to travel out of town, so they did not fast Monday. So they feel that something missing out of their life, out of his life. Okay? One of the righteous people said, I struggled with the Salah for 20 years. And after this, I enjoy the Salah for 20 years. Okay? That it was a struggle, like fulfilling obligation, okay? Okay, like somebody being in the job. And when 4:30 start every 5 minutes looking. Every 5 minutes looking. 2 minutes, okay, 5 o'clock, run, okay? And there is some people now became so relaxed and comfortable in their work, when 5 o'clock come, he didn't even pay attention after this next, you know, wow, man, 6 o'clock, I didn't know. And I was wondering why nobody else in the office, why everybody left, and I don't know. Why? Because this person is what? Enjoying what he's doing. So this righteous man is saying, I was in a struggle, trying really to focus in my salah, to make the salah in time, But after this, Allah blessed me, and this became is something that I love. So now I enjoy the salah after this for the next 20 years. All right, we'll stop here and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with His love, make us among those who love Him, and make us among those whom He loves. Ameen. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Allahumma.